This one? I don't hear anything. Do you? This is an old house. There's bound to be bumps in the night. Come to bed.
Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Ready Speaker. I am your host, Roland Urucci, and we're doing another film review today. So today's film, you just saw a clip of, and it is a film from 2023 called Cobweb. It's a Seth Rogen produced film, if I'm not mistaken. Let's go through the cast here. It's Lizzie Kaplan, who is in a Fleischman series. Watched that. I reviewed a little while ago. It wasn't that great. Antoni Starr, who is in The Boys as Homelander. So that's going to be a thing we can discuss later. And Woody Norman as Peter. And there's Cleopatra Coleman as Miss Devine, school teacher in this film. So a little bit of a rundown of the film. It's a horror film. It's a set, I think, in Pennsylvania, if I remember correctly, from the license plate. So there's the phone number was 610. I know that's around the New Jersey-Pennsylvania border as an area code. A boy, sort of the outcast in the community, shy, the family's very reserved and controlling of him, very wary of him, and he hears his tapping on his wall, and it freaks him out. And his parents are dismissive of it. The mother's a little bit overprotective, so there's a lot of fears. So they explain that a child vanished some years back, and that was traumatic, and that's why they're overprotective of their son. And it's all kinds of things. It's a school bully played by Luke Busey. I don't know if he's part of the Busey clan, but he did a great job of being a real prick of a kid. So how do I feel about this movie? I will tell you, it's one of the best suspenseful movies I've seen in a long, long time. Beautifully shot, lovely palettes. It's a little hard to get past Homelander's voice, because Antoni Starr does such a great job with him. This is not his fault. He just does a really, really great job of delivering lines. And he has so much range within Homelander that I think it's sort of... He just does so much with that character that anything else he does will probably have something like it, because he just really explores the hell out of that character. And Lizzie Kaplan, she does a great job. And What About the Fleischmans? I think so. Let me just look really quick here. I think it's, let's see. Fleischman's in Trouble. Yeah, she plays a great character in that. And I think she was probably my favorite character of that. And I know it was her point of view, sort of. At least that's how I remember the series, that she was coming together with that. And Woody Norman's Peter. I saw him in something else recently. Maybe it'll come to me. Actually, I'll look it up right now. And he is phenomenal. I don't think the movie would have been as good if it wasn't with him. The Last Voyage of Demeter, another horror film, a child review, or depending on how you see this, I reviewed already, but I've seen it. So, but yeah, great job in that as well. I think he's British, does a great American accent in this. Let me see where he's from. UK-based actor, does a great American accent in this. I think if you're gonna watch a film, you know, that you want suspense, that you want a real good setup, it's from the producers of Barbarian, which I reviewed. That was also a great thriller film. It's four main characters and some peripheral characters, nothing major. The setting is one house. It's really creepy. It's old. The color, like I said, in the house is amazing. Where they found the interiors, if it wasn't built, are amazing. It's probably not the same house. If you're looking outside, the stairs don't match. Nothing else matches. But that's okay. That's in the tradition of these sort of films, these horror, suspense, thriller films. And by the end, you have no idea what's going on with it. It's really gory in a good way. Not over the top. People aren't being, killed because of their faults, like some of the sins that in other films have, from promiscuity, arrogance, all those vices that sort of appear in other horror films. They sort of, and the killer kills them off. This is just batshit crazy thriller. Is just something happening that's really, really bad, and this kid is stuck in the middle of it, And he shows a lot of range, a lot of emotion. It's such a good story. And I watched it a couple of times because, and yeah, you can't leave, it's not long. I think it's, let's see where it is on time-wise. I'll read some specs here since I'm here on the IMDb. It only has 5.9 stars, which I think is not, I think deserves more. I think this deserves more. It's an hour and 28 minutes total. So you take out 5 minutes for credits. So it's an hour and set, hour and 20 minutes, which is not bad. It's around an 80 minute movie. The poster's great. I think, again, I think the lighting, the setup, let's see who the director of photography is for this. I know that sounds weird. It's directed by Samuel Bowden, written by Chris Thomas Devlin, which I think is, again, great stuff. It's based on, I think, influenced by Telltale Heart. And that's really cool. It sort of feels that way. This is the log line here. An 8-year-old boy tries to investigate the mysterious knocking sounds that are coming from inside the walls of his house, unveiling a dark secret that his sinister parents have kept hidden from him. They are sinister in this. I'm not going to spoil anything here. I don't think you need to spoil anything. It's a short movie. You can really watch it. You can really get into it. You can watch it with your family. It's not, there's no gratuitous stuff in it. There's definitely blood. There's definitely, jumps out of your chair. And there's the moments of going, oh my God, what just happened? But it's really well done. It's really, really, really well done. Like, stuff is just perfectly sinister, perfect word for the film, over the top, where, like, this makes no sense. They have a pumpkin patch in the back of the yard, and just all these pumpkins laid out, and what's more macabre in Halloween than that? There's tales of kids dying during trick-or-treating, again, going into this Americana myth of poisoning kids and killing kids. There's a bully that just, for the pure joy of bullying, bullies Peter, and that you don't like the kid. There's a teacher who just fish out of water trying to do the good job and gets caught in the crosshairs of something that she does not want to get caught in. It feels like it's set in the past, which is great, and I know that's a choice, but it's, there's smartphones in it. So even that is an interesting play, where on the second watch, I had to like think about that for a second. I was like, wow, I go, is it set in the 80s? Because like, why wouldn't they get help? But no, it's sort of anchored between. So it is like a myth. It's a fairy tale. I just think done really well. If you're going to watch a film that is a fairy tale, I would say this is the one to watch for this year. Definitely with Halloween coming up. It's really, really a rock solid film. I really, really enjoyed it. The pacing's right, the length is right, the lighting's right. I think the dialogue works really well. There's so many things you can like about it. People, maybe they want bigger things, or I don't know what they would think about as what would make it more. But to me, I'm trying to see even who is the DP for this puppy. Let me see if I can get the cast. And yeah, I'm looking, I'm sorry if I'm changing the lights here, but I'm just trying to see, here it is, cast and crew. And let's see, producers, I'm thinking, let me see, producer, executive, I think it was, Seth Rogen is a producer. He's not the head producer, but an executive, but he's a producer. So there's some, and even Goldberg, I think that's his buddy that he writes scripts with. So there's that, and then cinematography, Philip Lozano. Great job. Editing by Kevin Greutert and Richard Riffout. Really, really, really good job. The editing, I think, is top-notch in this. Makeup and prosthetics, wow, they got a whole shitload of people there. So, I mean, this art department, shitload of people. Sound department, shitload of people. Special effects, visual effects, shitload of people. I know they all do, but we're talking like a three-person, four-person cast with some peripherals, so you talk maybe 9-10 people total that are really active in the film. It's a very short list of credits. And like some people are just like, yeah, just the kids in school, a girl, boy, that's it. And most people don't have lines. If they do, they have a couple. So to have that kind of work involved in this, telling the story, is really impressive. Love the way it's lit. You probably saw I had a trailer or a clip up, something element of it. And I think it's just, I'm not going to put everything up there. But again, I think if you're really into movies and you want a good thriller, this is at 5.9, this is an underappreciated film. It should be talked about more. It really should. I think it's well done. And with a kid doing this kind of performance in it, wow. I think that this kid is great. I don't know how he'll age up for other roles, but for this film, I don't know if you can cast anybody. I have no idea who could be. Actually, out of all of these, I don't know who could be the character. I think they all did a great, great, great job. So a big thumbs up, a big like, a big whatever, stars, what do you want to say about this film. It's definitely worth a watch. I would you know, watch it as soon as you can. Watch it in October. Watch it before Halloween. It will freak you the hell out. At least it did for me. And you will enjoy a really, really good film. So that's it. That's Ready Speaker. Bye for now. And please subscribe, like, share if you like what I'm saying. Comment. Write something down. Please comment. I'd love to hear what you think. Maybe you think I'm an asshat. And I didn't wear a hat, but, you know, I have an ass. So, that's it. Okay, everybody. Bye.